गुड मॉर्निंग एंड जय हिंद डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 12 ज्योग्राफी ऑफ सिविल। आई वेलकम यू ऑल अगेन ज्योग्राफी क्लास एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस कॉमर्शियल लाइव स्टॉक डियरिंग ऑफ चैप्टर 5 बुक 1 फैमिली एक्टिविटीज। कॉमर्शियल लाइव स्टॉक डियरिंग एज द नेम यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड व्यापारिक पशुपालन। अर्लियर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड नोमैडिक हर्डिंग घुमंतू चरवाही। इन व्हिच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट नोमैड्स आर रिलाइंग ऑन देयर कैटल फॉर देयर सर्वाइवल व्हिच इज ऑफ सब्सिस्टेंस इन नेचर। बट द कॉमर्शियल लाइव स्टॉक रियरिंग एज द नेम कॉमर्शियल इट इज डन टू अर्न लॉट ऑफ प्रॉफिट। सो गिवन अनलाइक नोमैडिक हर्डिंग कॉमर्शियल लाइव स्टॉक रियरिंग इज मोर ऑर्गेनाइज्ड। Nomadic herding is not organized. That is traditionally done by shepherds or the herders in different parts of the world. But the commercial livestock rearing is more organized, developed on scientific basis, developed as an important occupation. In nomadic herding, their capital investment is meagre or very little. But in commercial livestock rearing, capital investment is more. It is capital intensive farming. A lot of capital is required. Commercial livestock ranching, R-A-N-C-H-I-N-G, ranching. Here word is come called ranching. Ranching is essentially associated with Western culture and is practiced on permanent ranches. Ranches means the pasture lands. Especially in North America, towards west of Rocky Mountains, there, it is difficult to grow wheat, but grasses are grown well naturally. So, the areas, number of pastures have been developed. And these parcels are divided into many parcels, with well fenced. And the cattle are allowed to graze only in one parcel of the ranch. Ranch means here, pasture. Then, the grasses is finished of first part or the parcel. Then cattle are allowed to move to the next, and then next, and slowly, slowly, again the cattle are coming to the first parcel of the range after the growth of the grasses in long period of time. So obviously, area is huge and big pastures have been developed. As given, these ranches cover large areas, huge areas. These are big in size and are divided into number of parcels. Khand mein bata hota hai. बहुत अच्छी तरह से इसकी इसका बाड़ा लगाया गया रहता है ताकि कैटल एक पार्सल से दूसरे पार्सल में न चले जाएं। ये लोग बहुत रेगुलेट वे में एक पार्सल में चराई करा के फिर दूसरे पार्सल की तरफ बढ़ते हैं। As given, when the grass of one parcel is grazed, animals are moved to another. It is right. The number of animals in pasture is kept according to the carrying capacity of the pasture. The size of pasture is important for keeping animals in its number. According to the size of parcel, they are keeping the animals. Thousands of animals are reared at a time. As I have told you, it is a capital intensive commercial livestock rearing. It is capital intensive. This is a specialized activity in which only one type of animal is reared. Not so many types of animals they are rearing at a time. One type of animal is reared. It is a specialization of this commercial livestock rearing. And the important animals which are reared are sheep, cattle, goats, horses. Sheep are rearing. Sheep rearing is very common there. Cattle rearing, goats and horses. Products such as meat, wool, hides and skin are processed and packed scientifically and exported to different world markets. Especially, there is a great demand of these meat and milk products, wool and hides, etc. in the European market. So, in South America, North America, parts of Australia, such type of animal livestock rearing is developed to meet the internal demand as well as find a good profit from the European market and other markets of Asia and Africa. Rearing of animals in ranching is organized on a scientific basis, as I have said to you, on scientific basis. the main emphasis, you can see the main emphasis here it is given. The main emphasis is on breeding. Nowadays, hybrid animals are reared, especially farmers are looking after the genetic improvement of these animals also. With genetic improvement also, they are having a number of programs related to health care of these animals through disease control, through vaccinations, etc. And this commercial livestock rearing is especially developed in New Zealand, Australia, Argentina, Uruguay and USA, etc. These are the important countries. You can see in map, this is the map showing areas of commercial livestock rearing. You can see in this map, this is rest of North America, this is South America, especially in Uruguay, Argentina, this is the part of tropical Africa, this is steppes of Eurasia, and this is the Australia. These are the regions where this commercial livestock rearing is developed. In board examinations, this is a common question. Highlight any five features of commercial livestock rearing. After 1 or 2 years, I have seen this question has repeatedly asked there in board examination. So I am going to suggest you how you have to prepare this particular topic, commercial livestock rearing. Five features you can prepare. First, you can say commercial livestock rearing is more organized and capital intensive. Second, you can say it is done over ranches which are divided into parcels. Third, the characteristic or the main feature of this specialized activity is that there is rearing of only one type of animal. Then you can see it is organized scientific type of commercial livestock rearing in which the main emphasis is on breeding, genetic improvement, disease control and health care of animals. And fifth feature you can write in which part of world it is developed. So you can write New Zealand, Australia, Argentina, Uruguay, USA are the countries where this farming is developed well. So in this way you have to prepare any five features or characteristics of commercial livestock rearing. Next topic we are going to start is the agriculture. Agriculture is not a new word. What is agriculture? Agriculture means tilling of land to produce or grow crops. Agriculture means plowing land, plowing soil to grow or raise crops, as well as it also includes animal husbandry, means livestock rearing, pisciculture, machli palan, sericulture, etc. All these are the part of agriculture. Agriculture is practiced under multiple combinations of physical and socio-economic conditions which give rise to different types of agricultural systems. Agriculture is dependent on the type of geography or the terrain of a particular area. Most of that, the type of agriculture developed in Himalayan region is not the same as it developed over the northern plains of India. Both are having different types. Why? Because of the geographical setting of these regions. In plain area, extensive agriculture is possible, but in rugged mountain features or rugged mountain regions, short field of agriculture can be developed only. As well as agriculture is also influenced largely by the socio-economic or technological development of the society. The farmers, where farmers are literate, the farmers are having more capital, they can develop scientific agriculture with a lot of investment in it. On the other hand, if farmers are illiterate, if they are having lack of capital, they are doing agriculture for their survival cost. So based on methods of farming, different types of crops are grown and livestock raised, and livestock rearing is also the part of agriculture. The following are the main agricultural systems. Agriculture is of basically two types. First, it is subsistence agriculture. The agriculture in which the main motive is behind to grow crop is the survival, subsistence agriculture, जीवन निर्वाह के लिए कृषि, जीवन निर्वाह कृषि। इस कृषि में फार्मर्स का मुख्य उद्देश्य होता है अपना और अपने परिवार का भरण पोषण, कॉल्ड एज सब्सिस्टेंस, जीवन निर्वाह। एंड अनदर टाइप इज कॉमर्शियल। इन कॉमर्शियल फार्मिंग द फार्मर्स आर हैविंग अ गोल टू अचीव दैट इज लॉट ऑफ प्रॉफिट। सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फर्स्ट पार्ट, सब्सिस्टेंस एग्रीकल्चर। नाउ सी, सब्सिस्टेंस एग्रीकल्चर इज वन इन विच द फार्मिंग एरियाज कंज्यूम ऑल। इट मीन्स द फार्मर्स आर ग्रोइंग क्रॉप्स फॉर देयर कंजम्पशन। इफ देयर एनी सरप्लस दे आर सेलिंग इन द मार्केट। सो गिवन कंज्यूम ऑल और नियरली सो ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट्स लोकली ग्रोन। इट कैन बी ग्रुप्ड इन टू कैटेगरीज। Subsistence agriculture is having further two types of it. Primitive subsistence, it means done by tribal community or the primitive societies, and second, intensive subsistence agriculture, which is done basically in densely populated regions of the world. In India, especially northern plains, intensive subsistence agriculture is well developed because of huge size of population in northern plains, which is very densely populated geographic division of India. Farmers are growing crops in same piece of land throughout the year, different crops they are growing. So there is use of land continuously throughout the year for growing crops. So in Hindi it is called Gahan Krishi, Gahan Jeevan Nirvah Krishi. Gahan means kisi ek zameen ke tukde pe pure saal lagatar koi na koi crop ko raise karna, ugana. As you know that in extensive commercial farming of prairies, as I am comparing, extensive commercial farming where wheat is the main crop in prairies of North America, in USA and Canada, they are having huge areas for cultivation of wheat crop, a single crop they are growing in a year, that is wheat. But in India, farmers are growing rice, farmers are growing wheat in different seasons, they are also growing watermelon, muskmelon. In India, especially said that the agricultural season, agriculture is having different seasons. Rabi season, Kharif season, Jaid cropping season. Three cropping seasons are there. Rabi, in winters, we are growing wheat, especially in North India. In Kharif season, almost all parts of our country, we are having paddy cropping. And Jaid, the short summer season between April to June, farmers are growing vegetables, cucumber, watermelon, muskmelon, etc. So throughout the year there is utilization of land for the production of crops called intensive subsistence agriculture. First, the primitive subsistence agriculture I'm going to discuss. You can see primitive subsistence agriculture or shifting cultivation is widely practiced by many tribes in tropics, especially in Africa, South and Central America, Southeast Asia. Here it is given, primitive subsistence agriculture, also known as shifting agriculture or shifting cultivation. In this, actually, the tribal community, which are also known as primitive societies, having lack of advancement in technology, their socio-economic development is not up to the mark. You can compare with the world, modern world, you can say. So, in the shifting agriculture, the farmers are first clearing a patch of land in forested area after clearing the forest by cutting down the trees and then burning all these. So here, farmers are clearing a patch of forested land to do agriculture. After 2 or 3 years or 5 years, when they see that the land is losing its ability or fertility to grow crops, they are leaving that area and moving to a new area in the forest and doing the same activity. They are slashing and burning the trees. So it is also known as slash and burn agriculture. Even further you can see, now here, The vegetation is usually cleared by fire and ashes add to the fertility of soil. What the forest they have cleared, they are burning it, and the ash which is produced after the burning of the forest and shrubs, they are adding with the soil for increasing its fertility. The shifting cultivation is thus also called slash and burn agriculture. It is migratory in nature. It is migratory in nature, in which farmers are migrating from one part of forest to another part and doing the same activity, clearing forest, burning, then utilizing ashes, mixing with the soil, increasing fertility, doing agriculture for 3 to 5 years, again leaving the place and moving to a new area of forest and doing the same. So the cultivated patches are very small, land holdings are very small, and cultivation is done with very primitive tools. Modern implements are not utilized. The primitive tools, prathamik aujar, kheti ke liye jo istemal hote hain, chote hal, daav, etc., they are utilized mostly. After some time, as given 3 to 5 years, the soil loses its fertility and the farmers shift to another parts and clear other patch of forest for cultivation. So as I have said you, it is migratory in nature. Farmers are shifting from one to another place in forested areas and doing the same activity. So ecologically it is not good practice. Almost now it is banned, but is still practiced by some of the tribal community who are living inside the forest. In India, especially in Northeast, Meghalaya, parts of Assam, Manipur, Mizoram and Nagaland, it is in practice. You can see the farmers may return to the earlier patch after some time. It is given as after 3 to 5 years when soil loses its fertility, farmers are shifting to a new area. But again, they can come back to the same place and they see that fertility has regained naturally. So, one of the major problem of shifting cultivation is that the cycle of jhum becomes less and less due to loss of fertility in different parcels. Jhum, cycle of jhum means this type of shifting from one to another place, again coming back to the same place. In Northeast India, this type of slash and burn agriculture or shifting cultivation is known as jhuming. It has different words given, name given in different parts of the world. As you can see here, for example, jhuming in Northeast states of India. In India, in Northeastern state, it is known as jhuming. Another name in different part of our country is given like Dahia in Bastar district of Chhattisgarh, Pamarabi, Ponda, Komban, Southern and Southeast India. So different names are given, Walray, Waltray in Eastern Rajasthan, Khil, etc. Many names are given to this type of farming in India, but almost banned in our country, as I have said you, but still practiced by some tribal communities here in Northeast. Especially it is famous in Northeast by the name of jhuming. Its name is Milpa in Central America and Mexico. It is known as Ladang in Indonesia and Malaysia. So this type of shifting cultivation is known by different names in different parts of the world. Second type we are going to discuss, intensive subsistence agriculture. As the name, intensive subsistence agriculture. This agriculture is also done. It is also practiced to survive, for subsistence or sustaining life. But here, lot of uses of chemical fertilizer, manures is there, lot of manual work, because it is mostly practiced in densely populated area, as well as modern equipments are also utilized. So, in this agriculture, productivity is higher per unit area, but overall production is lesser, as if you are comparing it with the extensive commercial farming of North America or towns of Australia. So given, this type of agriculture is largely found in densely populated regions of monsoon Asia. Densely populated regions of monsoon Asia. If you are looking after the map, you can see the areas of intensive subsistence farming. I am showing you areas of intensive subsistence farming. Here you can see that this part, This is called monsoon Asia, and here wet rice dominant cropping is going on. In the other parts of this monsoon Asia, you can see here other crops dominated. It means here wheat and other millets like jowar, bajra, sorghum are grown in these parts. So map is important to understand. Now see, in intensive subsistence farming, which is done basically in densely populated regions of monsoon Asia, there are two types of intensive subsistence agriculture. It is having also two types. First, intensive subsistence agriculture dominated by wet paddy cultivation. Paddy means rice. It is a type of agriculture which is characterized by dominance of the rice crop. This is in India. Which cropping season is going on? Can you recall? Yes, it is Kharif season with onset of monsoon. In Kharif season, almost in all parts of our country, farmers are growing paddy or the rice. So rice is the dominant crop. Land holdings are very small. Land holdings means jameen ka tukla jispe kheti ki jati hai. Khet chote aakar ke hai. Why? Because density of population is too much. Huge population is there. So obviously the population is more, land holdings are small. And another reason is the law of inheritance. Uttaradhikar ka niyam. Suppose a farmer is having 10 acres of land, having 5 sons. Again the land is divided among 5, 2 acres per head. Then they are having 2 or 3 children. So what will happen? Slowly the land is divided into or among this family, and slowly it becomes smaller and smaller day by day. So due to the law of inheritance, the land holdings are small. Land holdings means khet jispe kishi ki jati hai, wo chote akar ke hote hai. Kyunki population density bhi jyada hai, aur saath hi saath uttaradhikar ka niyam, law of inheritance ki wajah se jameen har generation mein badhti chali jati hai. Farmers work with the help of family member, leading to intensive use of land. Intensive use of land means maximum use of minimum land. Intensive use of land means maximum use of minimum land. Suppose farmers are having average 1 or 1.5 acre of land. So they are growing different crops in different seasons of the year. They are not leaving land to rest. They are utilizing the land continuously to grow different crops throughout the year. So this is called intensive use of the land. It means maximum use of minimum land. But in extensive commercial farming of prairies or in Australia, there is minimum use of maximum land. Their land is too much, but they are growing a single crop in a year. In northern plains of India, where intensive subsistence agriculture is dominant, here land is limited and there is a lot of uses of this land to produce more and more crops. So maximum use of minimum land is here. Further given, farmyard manure is used to maintain the fertility of soil. Farmers are rearing cattle side by side, and what the manures they are make, they are having, they are using to maintain the fertility of soil, as well as lot of chemical fertilizers nowadays are also utilized. So now there is demand to develop organic farming because of overuse of chemical fertilizer. Land is degrading, soil is losing its long-term fertility. But the per unit area production is high. Per head production is low because population is too much. So per labor productivity is low, but production per unit area per hectare acre is high as compared to extensive commercial farming. Second type of intensive is that intensive subsistence agriculture dominated by crops other than paddy due to difference in relief. Relief means the physiographic setting, either it is a mountain or plateau or a plain region. Climate type. If climate is supportive for growing different crops throughout the year, either the climate is suitable for growing crop only one time in a year. Different types of soils. Soils are different in different parts of the region of monsoon Asia, and they support different type of crops. It is not practical to grow paddy in many parts of monsoon Asia. It is right. In many parts of monsoon Asia, it is not possible to grow paddy crop. So what happens in this part where paddy is not possible to grow, wheat, soybean, barley, sorghum are grown in like northern China, Manchuria, North Korea, North Japan, etc. But in India, especially in northern place, which is known as the food bowl of India, farmers are growing wheat during winters called Rabi cropping season. Wheat is the main crop. Gram, etc. are grown. Mustard, all these are grown in Rabi season. In Rabi season, the main crop is the wheat. In Kharif, paddy or the rice is the main. In northern plain, farmers are growing rice also. And in short Jaz season, from April to June, that is called short summer season or cropping season, is known as Jaz, Z-A-I-D, Jaz. They are growing vegetables, cucumber, watermelon, muskmelon, etc. So in India, wheat is grown in western parts of Indo-Gangetic plains. Punjab, Haryana, western Uttar Pradesh are the areas where wheat is produced a lot. And millets are grown in drier parts of western and southern India, especially in Karnataka, South India, Karnataka, Plateau region, parts of Tamil Nadu, parts of Rajasthan in northwest. Farmers are growing millets. Millets means mote anaj. Millets means mote anaj, jaise jowar, bajra, ragi. इन सब की खेती होती है ड्रायर एरियाज में. देन यू कैन से अनदर एग्जांपल कॉर्न, मेज, मेज माने मक्का. मक्के की खेती भी होती है बिकॉज इट रिक्वायर्स लिटिल वाटर एज कंपेयर टू पैडी. सो हियर मोस्ट ऑफ द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ दिस टाइप ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर आर सिमिलर टू दोज डोमिनेटेड बाय वेट पैडी एक्सेप्ट द इरिगेशन इज ऑफन यूज्ड. इन intensive subsistence cropping dominated by rice or paddy crop, there rainfall is important for crops, their irrigation is not utilized generally. But in wheat farming or farming of these millets, especially in drier areas, irrigation is often used during winters. And the farmers of India, especially in Punjab, Haryana, UP, parts of Bihar, they are Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, they are growing wheat, they are using irrigation to provide moisture to the soil for better production of crops. So this all for subsistence agriculture. Now we are going to discuss about the other type of agriculture. First here it is introduction is given, you can see. The Europeans colonized many parts of the world and they introduced some of other forms of agriculture such as plantations, which were mainly profit-oriented large-scale production system. Plantation agriculture. Are you observing this figure? Here it is given. Tea cultivation. So nicely you can see. In India, tea plantations, coffee plantations, rubber plantations were developed by the Europeans, especially by the British. They have developed all these plantations in India, plantation crops, especially tea, because that time there was a great demand of tea of India to the European market. Still this time, there is a great demand. But today, more or less, all plantations are owned by Indians. Earlier, they were developed as well as owned by the Britishers. So in next class, we'll discuss about the plantation agriculture. Today, I'm summarizing about the subsistence agriculture. Just see once again. Subsistence agriculture. First part is primitive subsistence agriculture done by tribal community. As we have discussed, it is also known as slash and burn agriculture, shifting cultivation, as it is migratory in nature. You can recall. Second type, intensive subsistence agriculture, which is of two types. First, dominated by wheat paddy cultivation, and second, intensive subsistence agriculture dominated by crops other than paddy, and it is mostly practiced in monsoon Asia. So the next class we will discuss about the plantations and other types of farming. Thank you. Have a nice day.